The book of Jeremiah, the 18th chapter, the 3rd through the 5th verse, and I just give God all the honor, praise, and glory for allowing me to stand before his people. I just thank him for this opportunity. I thank him for each and every one of you. I thank him for my lovely wife. I just thank God for another day.
Amen.
To be in his house.
Amen.
Jeremiah, the 18th chapter, let us stand in reverence to God's word if you can. Jeremiah, the 18th chapter, the 3rd through the 5th verse. Jeremiah 18, the 3rd through the 5th verse. It says, "So I did as he told me and found the potter working at his wheel. But the jar he was making did not turn out as he hoped. So he crushed it into a lump of clay again and started over." May the Lord add a blessing to the reading here and an application of his holy and righteous word. Go ahead and take your seats. If you're looking for a title for today's message, if you're looking for a topic for today's text, it is, "You are broken to be blessed." Let the church say amen.
Amen.
You are broken to be blessed. You are broken for a benefit. How many of you know sometimes in the medical profession, we have joints that may not align right? We have things going on, and doctors say, "You know, the only way I can fix what's wrong with you, the only way I can fix this joint, the only way I can fix this ailment is if I break it and reset it." Now you say, "Well, what do you mean? You got to break my jaw to reset." Yes, I need to break your jaw to reset it so it can operate how it should operate. Same thing can go for knees, it can go for ankles, it can go for a lot of different parts of our body. Doctors will take that joint, they'll take it, they'll break it, they'll maneuver it, they'll fix it, they'll make it the way it ought to be, because in the first place, something was wrong with it. Let the church say amen. Now, when you look at the scripture, Jeremiah is talking about the children of Israel. He's talking about you and I. He's talking about how they are in his hands. We are, you are, we're in God's hands. Tim Fowler sang the song last week. He's got the whole world in his hands. How many of you are grateful that you're in God's hands? But I need you to understand. Yeah, go ahead and clap for that. Amen. But I need you to understand, while you're in his hands, from time to time, you might be broken.
Amen.
I don't get a lot of amens when people say that. From time to time, you might be broken. What does that mean? From time to time, God may need to strip you of some things. God may need to take some stuff from you. God may need to knock you down a few pegs so you realize who you are, whose you are, and what you are. Amen, somebody. Quite often, we'll get to a place where we think we've done all this stuff by ourselves, and we forget about God, and he has to remind you by breaking him.
Amen.
Now, the process don't kill you, but the process is meant to get you on the right page. Let the church say amen. So often we wonder why things go on in our lives, and we wonder why we have to go through stresses day in and day out. Many of you right now are in the process of being broken by God in order for you to be used fully. Let the church say amen. You keep wondering why you can't get your house right. You keep wondering why you can't get your finances right. You keep wondering why your family ain't right, because you need to be broken so you can realize who you are. Let the church say amen. I don't need the kids to leave the sanctuary. Let the church say amen. You and I, we have to understand that God will break you in the midst of your situation. See, it said here that the potter had begun already to make something. Come on, church. He had already begun to make something, and as he made it, as it was in the people's hands, or as it was in his hands, there was a problem with it. The jar was marred. There was a mark on it. There was an imperfection. There was an attitude problem. There was a disobedience problem. Let the church say amen. There was a not tithing problem. There was some stuff going on, and God said, "I've got to take this in my hand. I've got to break this thing up. I've got to remake it so I can use." You and I have to understand that when you are broken, when things go on, you've got to take it just like Job did. Let the church say amen. What did Job say? Job said in Job 13:50, he said, "Though he slay me, yet will I trust in him." Amen. Many of us have not gotten to that place where we say, "I trust God in the midst of my problems." Many of us have not gotten to that place where we say, "I trust God in the midst of my circumstance." But I'm telling you today, you need to get to that place. When you have problems, you have to say, "God, I trust you." Amen, somebody. When things ain't going right, you got to say, "God, I trust you." When things don't look right, you got to say, "God, I trust you." When your family's turned their back on you, you got to say, "God, I trust you." When your finances are funny, you got to say, "God, I trust you." When people turn their Sister Myra, for you and I. Amen. It doesn't matter what you look like before you were broken. Let the church say amen. Amen. God has a plan for your life. You might say, no, I'm a little old nobody. No, you are something to God. And he's going to use your story to bless somebody else. Let the church say amen. You got to remember what Jeremiah said in 29:11. He said, for I know the plans I have for you. Somebody should be excited right there. For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you. Somebody should be excited. And not to harm you, but plans to give you hope and a future. You ought to be excited. Because God said, before you came, before I came, he said, I've got some plans for you. I want you to make it. I want you to be victorious. I want you to prosper. I want you to have joy. I want you to have peace. Somebody should be excited right now. Because God was thinking about you when you was in your mess. God was thinking about you when you weren't thinking about him. He said, guess what? It's going to be all right, Dale. Guess what? It's going to be all right. Guess what? It's going to be all right.
Church. Amen.
Your account is in the green for a few weeks.
you stop coming to church. But let a check bounce from here to Muskegon, Michigan. You up here on the altar. Lord, I need you. Like I never needed you before. That wasn't a joke. That was good. All right. I'm done. Can I be done? Is that all right? Oh, yeah. All I'm telling you, and all I was trying to tell you today, was this: that as we journey with the Master, Reverend Perkins, you know, as we journey with the Master, from time to time, Tasha, we get distracted by other things, and eventually, those things that distract us begin to get more of our attention than God. And during the midst of that, sometimes God says, okay, so there's something wrong here. Let me fix this. And that fixing don't always feel good. And that fixing, sometimes your family, sometimes your friends run on. But that fixing, by Felicia, that fixing is for your benefit. Amen. Let us all stand.